Today, I want to talk about feed rules and how powerful it is to optimize and customize your Google Shopping feed. Feed rules is often underused in Google Merchant Center, but it's a very powerful feature of Google Merchant Center. So let's talk about what they are and how you can use and what are the use cases for feed rules, right? Feed rules allows you to change your existing feed that is pushed to Google Merchant Center. A sample use case is if you want to add your brand to every single title, right? So instead of the title being just the title, you want brand space title. You can do that easily via Google Merchant Center's feed rules. Another thing is that let's say you want to bulk change a word. Instead of Nike, let's say you want to replace it all with Adidas, right? These are some of the things that you can do very easily and very powerful in a very powerful way using feed rules. So let's see how you can make these changes. Click on feeds in your Google Merchant Center. Select the feed which is your primary feed, right? And here for me it is the Content API. One restriction for feed rules is that you have to do it country by country. You cannot have a global settings. So click on feed rules. Now, if right now you can see that in the United States, the default rule is take from Content API, right? That's my primary API. So the idea is take all attributes that is coming from Content API. Now I want to like slightly change it, right? So let me try to customize the title. I'm going to customize the title to add brand in front of it. Okay? So I would say set to Content API brand, then a space. You don't want these two words to be without any spaces. And then title. So we have the attribute title is going to be changed to Content API brand. Then a space, then Current API title. There is always a default value that is here, that is title has no value yet, then just apply the default. You can ignore this for the time being. And you can see the product here. You can kind of search by the product ID and see how it has changed. So if you look closely, it was earlier 5-panel cap burnt orange, it has been changed to United by blue space 5-panel camp cap. So let's just to show you that it has changed, let me add something else as well, right? So you can see here United by blue and 5-panel camp cap. So you can just very easily see a preview here. I'm going to remove the and here because it doesn't add any value. I'm just going to stick with my simple space. So once you see that things are working, you can test it with any product you want. You just have to search it by the item ID. But once you see a preview, you can click on Save as Draft. Now, what Google does is that you can immediately apply the changes if you want, right? Or you can say that I want to test changes. What test changes does is that it goes through all the products in your feed, applies the rule and shows you a rough information about what are the things that has been changed, right? It will tell you 1,000 products changed or 500 products changed, what is the impact of it, etc. So if you are very confident about it, just go ahead and click on apply. But if you want to like see the differences that it has, it is going to make, click on test changes. One word of caution, test changes take a lot of time, right? It at least takes 15 minutes before you can see any change. But let's click on test change. So as I said, it will take 10 to 20 minutes. We'll come back once this is complete. Hey guys, as you can see, the test has completed. Now let's see what the results are. So we can see if the status changes because of this rule that we applied. You can see that nothing like that is going to happen. It says 97 items will be changed, and you can see what is the current title and what will be the new title. Any new issues that will be introduced? Apparently, yes, one new issue will be introduced. Please note that this is not a critical issue. This most probably will just make give a warning. Google typically truncates a long title, and none of the other issues will remain changed. And once you're satisfied with the test results, you can click on the apply button. And once you if you click on apply button, all of these rules will be applied for your products in United States. I'm not going to do it because I'm not going to change this merchant center with this new feature, but this is a very easy way for you to make changes to Google Merchant Center products. And you can put a lot of conditions. I'm not going into the advanced uses of fee tools, but simple fee tools can go a long way in optimizing your shopping feed. Thanks a lot for watching the video. If you have any doubts, please let us know.